Start though in the West, where the Clippers joined the group of teams that have clinched playoff spots, now numbering 10 after they won in Minnesota. LA sits fifth at the moment, but get this, they are as close to number three Portland as they are to the eighth place Spurs. And as they celebrated last night, Doc Rivers reminded his crew that few expected them to land anywhere in the top eight.
Hey, ESPN predictor.
Right.
33 wins. That's what they said. Charles Barkley, 33 wins. Vegas, 33 wins. And we go up to the damn playoffs. Yes, sir.
Fun scene in the locker room last night. Lou Williams tweeted, for the record, Clipper Nation, this is a very special moment in my career to make the playoffs with this particular group. Reporting live from the Underdog. From Lou. Zeke.
Oh, see, that ain't right.
Now, so maybe you could pull that off.
No, I can pull that off.
It was cold outside, huh?
And underneath, you can't see, I had the comeback boots like Russ got.
You had the comeback boots, too.
That's wrong. Y'all shouldn't have done me like that.
You knew they were going.
But it's sweet, though. But come on now. You got to give me credit. You got to give me some credit.
It's a look. It's a look. You know, if you're a cynic, you could look at the NBA and say, you know, more than half the teams make the playoffs. So maybe you should be making the playoffs. But for the Clipper team that wasn't expected to make the playoffs, wasn't there last year, it is a big deal. And for players and coaches who work from, well, in the offseason, but starting in camp in September, what does it mean?
It means that, A, you've exceeded expectations, and B, you get a chance to play for the championship. And I know it may not mean a lot to people who don't play the game, but for people who do play, they do want to have an opportunity to play for the biggest prize and to play for the championship. And it warms my heart to see teams still striving to make the playoffs and want a chance to compete to wear the ring. And there's nothing like experience. Experience is the best teacher. And to see guys like this celebrating during the season, you know, a professional team, professional players celebrating making the playoffs, getting this type of joy.
Like kids. Like
real
kids.
Enthusiasm, real excitement. It's not contrived. It's not made up. I mean, these are special moments, and this is what it's all about.
I totally disagree with the cynics. I think this notion that half the league makes it, so therefore it's no big deal, is comical. And I base that on years of being around teams that were nowhere near the playoffs.
Sure, yeah.
And seeing how miserable they are. You know, finishing out a season knowing that, you know, sounds great. Oh, you're going on vacation. You're going to have 2 extra months and all that. Well, you know, you're going to have 2 extra months to watch other guys compete for the top spot in your profession. Yeah. So absolutely, I think it's important that this Clippers team in particular, given the way they've handled all of the changes that have come at them the past few years, you didn't just lose your best player at the trade deadline this year. You lost 3 iconic franchise players in successive situations. You know, Chris Paul leaves, Blake leaves, DeAndre Jordan. I mean, you know, you're talking about guys who were the pillars of a playoff-bound team year after year to be snatched away, for them to still be here. For Doc Rivers to get out of these guys what he's gotten out of them deserves credit, but it also points to the professionalism and the grind of the players in that locker room that they've done what they have. Because, as they mentioned, they weren't pegged for this spot. There were a bunch of other teams we assumed would be in one of those playoff spots, and the Clippers rose up and snatched one.
Not only were they not picked to make the postseason, but they traded away ostensibly their best player on February 6th when they sent Tobias Harris, as well as Mike Scott and Boban Marjanovic, to Philadelphia in a move that seemed to signal that they were planning more for the future than for now. And yet, they've gotten better since then, 15-5 to move into the spot we showed you a little bit earlier. How has Doc Rivers pulled this particular rabbit out of his hat?
I mean, I think we heard the chant at the end of that video, family. Like, they took away some of the bigger personalities in that locker room and stuck with the guys who are the blue collar, grind it out, show up every day, do your job and going about your business, crew. And sometimes in this league, that is what you need to rely on to get you through the kind of season that they've dealt with. Now, you know, a lot of people gonna look and say, well, they don't get their draft pick. So, you know, you snatch that away. I would tell you that even a 6 or 7 game trip to the playoffs is gonna be more valuable for the guys in that locker room and also for your recruiting efforts in free agency than anybody you would have selected with that draft pick.
I totally agree with you. And also, when it also just says that teams beat talent. And when you talk about teams, I'm talking about teams and chemistry. You know, you can have a very talented team, and we've seen very talented teams in this league. They fail. But we've seen a lot of teams in this league with great chemistry, great family atmosphere, great bonding, who adhere to a game plan. They can go out and compete, and they can go out to and win. I think two things have happened. I think Doc Rivers, this may be the best coaching job that he's ever done with a basketball team. Also, I think this is the most fun he's had in years coaching a basketball team. And the third thing I would add is, or ask of all of us, did we overestimate the West in terms of talent and teams? Because at the start of the season, we thought the West was, you know, the teams were, you know, were out of the stratosphere.
Thought there were going to be 10, 11 teams competing, really high-end teams competing for those 8 spots.
And we didn't think the Clippers would have a chance.
Right, right.
And some of us said, okay, well, maybe they can compete for the 8th spot, maybe. Mm-hmm. But no one thought that they would have a chance to get to 3. So is the talent that great in the West, or has it slipped a lot from a team standpoint? I think from a team standpoint, the talent has really slipped a lot in the West.
We certainly overestimated the Lakers collectively, whether you were, you know, sort of delusional that the Lakers were going to contend, or like most of us thought they'd be somewhere between 5 and 8 in the postseason. We overestimated there. By the way, to clean up something Sekou said, by clinching the playoffs, the Clippers lose their first round pick to Boston. Before we go to break.
Boston
has 27 picks.
Half the first round.
Before we go to
Boston
break.
Boston and the New England Patriots. They
have all the draft
picks. They got all the draft picks.
Is it entirely dependent on matchup? Can the Clippers win a postseason series, yes or no?
Yes, absolutely they can. Yes.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question. And Isaiah's right. We overestimated a lot of teams in the West. New Orleans, the Lakers.
Yep.
Several teams we assumed would be in that mix did not live up to the hype.
Minnesota.
Another one.
Yeah. And by the way, if you think it's no big deal making the playoffs, tell that to long-suffering fans of the Sacramento Kings, of the Orlando Magic right now, of Minnesota, which ended the previous longest playoff drought last year. It's a big deal, that crew, that's for sure. You can get spoiled if your team is...